Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. My name is Claudio. So glad that you're here. If you are a first-time visitor, please do click the like button, consider subscribing, and share this video with your friends. If you are returning, thank you so much as well. In this video, I'm going to walk you through how you can create this color profile photo effect in Adobe Express. So without any further ado, let's go ahead and dive right in. Here I am at the home screen of Adobe Express. I'm going to start by clicking on the plus sign and create a custom size graphic. And for this one, I'm going to go ahead and go with the default here and click on next. You could always change the size later on. And now what I'm going to do here next is I'm going to click on the background here and I want to choose a dark background. I'm going to go with black here. And the next thing I'll do is import the picture that I'm going to be using for that color profile effect. And I'm going to go ahead and click on photos here. And I've got a photo set up on my desktop. So let's go ahead and find that here. And that should be, let's see here. Let's go ahead and locate that. And we got it right here. So I'm going to be using this one as my project photo here, my profile photos. You can see I've got a background there. So I'm gonna go ahead and remove the background and let Adobe Express run its magic with the AI here. There we go, pretty good. I'm gonna go ahead and click check okay. And I'm going to go ahead and make this a bit larger here. So I'm going to size it up about here. And that's pretty good there. So now the next step is I'm going to create a duplicate of this photo. We're going to go ahead and click right here where it says duplicate. And I'm going to go ahead and move this one actually behind. So there's several ways you can do that. You can go either in the stacks here on the layers. You can drag it to the back because I want that second photo to actually have the effect. Or you can use the layer menu right here to move it up or down. And so with this photo selected, we're going to jump over here to the effects. And we're going to go to filters. As you can see, there's already the Duotone set up, and that's the one I'm going to be using. And for this one, to create that color profile, I'm going to actually customize the shadows and the highlights here. For the shadows, I'm going to make those, let's see, I want those to be black. So let's make sure, okay, yes, that's exactly what I want. What I may do is go just a little lighter with the black. So let's move this up a bit. And right here on the color, I'm gonna go ahead and just lighten that black up just a bit so it's visible behind that black background. And then for this color here, this is the one that I'm going to be using for the highlight. The yellow actually looks pretty good, but let me go ahead and click on more. I want a really brighter yellow, maybe right there. That's good enough. I can always click on it and adjust it right here to make it really bright yellow. So let's see, there we go. And then what I'm going to do with my arrow keys, I'm going to slide that back and I'm going to create another duplicate of that one. And again, we're going to adjust the stacks here, the layers. We're going to bring that one to the back. And you notice the menu is still here. So now I'm going to go ahead and choose a different color here. And we're going to use the arrow key to move that. See if I can go bright red. Okay, that's pretty good right there. And we're gonna repeat the process. We're gonna duplicate once again, and I'm gonna move it back like that. Now I could have started backwards. I could have started with the color first and just lay it on stack one by one, but you know, different processes, you can go different routes to do that. Let's go ahead and go with a pink here. Let's see, we're gonna go with that right there. It's a kind of a purpley pink. So let's see here, click on here. We want that to be brighter. There we go. And again, I'll use my keys here. And now what I could do just to help this out a bit, I'm going to go with the shadows here. The shadows, let's see what happens if I make it brighter. Yeah, I think I'm going to do that. So I probably could have done that on each one. So let's see, I'm going to do a little shortcut here. I'm going to copy that hex code there. And then when I click on each layer, I can go back to the black. And the reason I'm doing this is to make the colors pop a little more. There we go. I'm going to go back to the yellow here and paste that in. Yeah, that now it's a lot more visible. And I'm gonna go one more here. I'm gonna duplicate that one and remove that. I say not remove, but move it down. And I'm gonna go with a blue. Which of these? I think that one here. and then I'll adjust it like that. Now, mine is not a true profile, like from the side, but that's the best photo I had for now. What I just did is click out here and selected them all, and I can now align them to the top, and I think that's pretty good right there. I'm happy with the way that looks. And actually, one more time, I'll select them all and I will group them, so now when I move them, they all move together. Cool. All right, I like the way that looks. Once I'm done, I can click on download here and click on start download, choose the PNG, and I can go ahead and share this with my friends and on social. And I hope you enjoyed this one. So now it's your turn to create your own color profile photo using Adobe Express. If you have any comments or questions about this video, please do drop it in the comment section below. Don't forget, hit that like button, subscribe, click the bell to be notified for future videos, and please do share this video with your friends. Thanks so much for stopping by and watching this video. And as always, be good to one another. Peace.